A very good morning to all of you. I wish you a very happy academic new year, and I welcome you all to my course Disaster Management. In today's lecture, I am going to talk about the general meaning of disaster and so few terminologies. You need to be familiar with all these terminologies, otherwise you cannot understand the details of these disaster management course in further lectures. So listen this lecture very carefully and note down all the new terminologies from this lecture. And here my details is given in this slide. And before going to start the topic, that is meaning of disaster, let us discuss a few terms about your syllabus. At first, you need to know about your syllabus. In unit 1, we will discuss understanding disasters, that is meaning of disaster and their related terminologies, understanding the concepts of definition of disaster, hazard, vulnerability, risk, importance. And I am going to discuss few new terminologies in the first lecture. And in unit 2, the classification of disasters, mainly types, trends, causes, consequences, control of disasters, and various natural disasters, man-made disasters. And we are now also facing a disaster, that is COVID-19 pandemic. And this is biological disaster. And this is also a natural disaster, and I am going to discuss in detail all these in the classification of disasters, that is in unit 2. Then in unit 3, the prevention and mitigation. Prevention and mitigation. Mitigation is a new term for you. Mitigation means how we can prevent and how we can minimize the loss of life, minimize the loss of property. This is in mitigation. And in third unit, we also discuss disaster mitigation, meaning, concept, disaster preparedness. Preparedness means how do you prepare ourselves for the disaster. Actually, we cannot prevent disasters. That's why we have to be prepared to prevent how we can minimize the loss of life, loss of property, and to save our environment. Then preparedness, capacity development, awareness during disaster. And in unit 4, application of science and technologies, and also there are new technologies used how to predict some disasters. Now we can predict some natural disasters like cyclones. So how do you predict? And there are some other natural disasters we cannot predict, like earthquake. So by using science and technology, we can predict few natural disasters. So we will discuss all these in our unit 4. And in today's lecture, we are going to learn and we are going to discuss introduction, means disaster management definition, what is disaster, the general meaning of disaster, then the few terminologies like hazard, risk management, vulnerability, then prevention, preparedness, responses, all these new terms we are going to learn. Let us start with the definition of disaster. If we split the term, we can have dis plus aster. Disaster, the word used by French, Greek, Italian, and other ancestors, is giving a meaning that whenever the alignment of stars in bad position, a bad event will happen. Dis means bad and aster means star. So from the social view point, we can say an extreme event within the earth system that results in death, injury to humans and damage or loss of valuable goods is called disaster. Scientifically, behind every natural disaster that occur on Earth's surface, at least a single or a multiple geographical phenomenon or Earth system processes, and there is an active, continuous, systematic and in a cyclic manner. These natural phenomena or processes are vulnerable to human and other living beings. Their property as well as environment as known as geohazards. So nowadays, our human community have started facing disasters very frequently. This is because of our own intervention with the nature improperly through the various developmental activities and implement different hazards without understanding such natural earth system processes. We are also facing this time COVID-19. This is a disaster also. This is biological disaster, and we are going to discuss during the classification of different disasters. Volcanic eruption, this is geohazards vulnerable to become disaster if we live close to them. And similarly, due to several past hazards, flooding events, not only the fertile flood plains, and it also can be occur in various regions. We human beings are blessed with land, water, mineral and several other natural resources important to our life. These natural resources are developed due to the several earth system processes, which would be of highly there are various processes, and but we are all can be considered as good disaster for the evolution of human community. But in this lecture, we are going to learn that is not a good disaster for us. These are all hazards and also not wanted for. And according to the general concept, disaster can be defined as, and it is also included in Disaster Management Act in 2005, and it is defined as: disaster is a catastrophe, mishap, calamity or grave occurrence in any area arising from natural or man-made causes or by accident or negligence, which results in substantial loss of life. That means in disasters, various loss of life occurs and human suffering or damage to the destruction of property or damage to and degradation of management environment and also the nature. So disaster is unwanted and it is not controllable at all, but we can at least prevent some, we can adopt some habits so that we can prevent disaster. According to United Nations, disaster is the occurrence of sudden or major misfortune which disrupts the basic fabric and normal functioning of the society of the or the community. So I think now it is clear what is the definition of disaster. So disaster is, here from this slide you can see, a disaster is an event that occurs in most cases suddenly and unexpectedly. Now there are some new terminologies. You have to know these terminologies, otherwise you cannot understand in our further lectures. So these new terminologies you need to know, and you have to remember these also. The first one is disaster risk, and from this definition you can the risk means a risk occurs when a community is exposed to hazards and it is likely to be adversely affected through its impact. So risk is a measure of the expected loss due to a hazard event, and occurring in a given area over a specific time period. And then the new terminology for you is disaster risk management. From this, the term also you can understand, this is the first one is disaster risk, and now risk management means how to manage all this disaster risk. So disaster risk management is a systematic process which involves using the administrative directives, organizations and operational skills and capacities towards implementing strategies, policies and improved coping capacities to lessen the adverse impact of the hazards and their possibility of disaster. So disaster risk management aims at avoiding, lessening and transferring the adverse effect of hazards. Now, disaster risk reduction. By this term, you can understand that here we are going to discuss how to reduce all the risk, means management and reduce, these are reduction, these are quite similar. And in this lecture, we are learning only the definition only. Then in our next lecture, we will learn in detail of these. Risk already discussed, and risk assessment. Risk assessment means the level of potential losses that a society or community considers acceptable given existing social, economic, political and cultural, technical and environmental condition. Then the risk assessment, after risk assessment, this risk management. Risk management already discussed, and then risk transfer. Risk transfer means the process or formally or informally shifting the financial consequences. This is actually the capacity. Then we will discuss the contingency planning, then coping capacity, then critical facilities, disaster risk reduction. After that, adaptation capacity. In adaptation, that means the level of potential losses. Capacity, the combination of all the strengths, attributes, the reduced available within the community and society. Then climate change. In climate change, climate change means there are various climate changes, and there are various natural disasters which occurs in seasonal basis, and these are like floods, like cyclones. These are all due to the change in climate. Climate change means we all know the global warming. The global warming occurs due to excess increase in carbon dioxide in our atmosphere. So increase in carbon dioxide causes the average temperature is increasing. That's why the overall temperature of the earth system is increasing, and this is called the global warming. And due to global, the carbon dioxide is one of the greenhouse gases. There are various greenhouse gases like methane, water vapor. These are three important greenhouse gases: carbon dioxide, methane and water vapor. We will learn details in our next lectures. So due to climate change, we can have various natural disasters. Then hazard. Hazard is a destructive phenomenon or event. Hazard could be anything from earthquakes, storms, volcanic eruption, industrial events, etc. Though hazards in themselves are not disasters, they become so when they cause destruction of populations, and either directly or indirectly. This could include destruction of land, crops, physical infrastructure, etc. This is possible to map hazards in advance. This mapping could provide information about areas where storms could strike, the land that will be distracted by floods, the height and strength of tsunami waves, and the areas that could be devastated by volcanic ashes. And then mitigation. Mitigation is actually mitigation, the term means reducing risk or loss from the occurrence of any undesirable event. This is an important element for any insurance business so as to avoid unnecessary losses. In general, mitigation means the minimized degree of any loss or harm. So, in case of disaster management, we will discuss mitigation when we will discuss the disaster management cycle. And preparedness means the term indicates that how do we prepare ourselves for the sudden disaster. As we know from the definition part that disaster occurs suddenly. So, we cannot actually prevent disasters. That's why we have to be prepared for disaster. How do we prepare for a particular disaster? How do we prepare for cyclone and for tsunami, for earthquake, for landslide? And we will discuss in detail in our next lectures. But at this time, you have to remember all these new terminologies. And then prevention is very easy to understand, that how do you prevent. Actually, natural disaster cannot be prevented, but we can change our habits so that we can change, stop the climate change process. If we can stop the climate changing process, if we can stop deforestation, then we can actually prevent some of the natural disasters like cyclones, flood. So, from today's lecture, I wish you can understand all these new terminologies. If you have any query, you can come to the discussion forum and we will discuss about these terminologies if you have any query. So, follow the next lecture in tomorrow's class and we will study these terminologies in detail. And thank you.